Hello student, welcome to the video lecture course for computer aided manufacturing. So today we are going to discuss about the part 2 of quantitative analysis in group technology and cellular manufacturing. So we have seen how to quantitatively analyze these different group technology and cellular manufacturing. So in this video we'll mainly focus on part 2, which is how to arrange the machine in the group technology cell. So to give the idea, what we have seen in the first video is we have arranged the part and the machines together in a cell. Now while using the Euler method, we will arrange the machines in a cell only. How to logically optimize that arrangement of sequence? I'll provide you the proper background also for this. Now if you do the summary of the our part 1, where we use the rank order clustering technique for grouping the part and machines. So this was the initial interaction of the parts with the machines, and then while after using the rank order clustering technique, we have arranged the part and the machine in a cell. Now the next task is how to arrange these machines in a such a way so that we get the most logical arrangement. It's been where number of parts moves from one location, let's say part number of part moving from machine 1 to 2, or let's say 3 to 2, or maybe 6 to 2. So how to arrange this sequence? So that we will discuss in this video lecture is. So this is the arranging the machine sequence. Now for arranging the machine in a group technology cell, we use the Euler method. So this method mainly uses the sum of the flow from and to for each machine in a cell. So for example, I will provide you the clear idea what is this from and to. So let's say for example, we have the four machines in a cell. Number of component will move from one machine to the second machine. So this shows from one machine 25 components move to the fourth machine. From second machine 30 components move to the first machine. From third machine 10 components move to the first machine and 40 components move to the second machine. And from the fourth machine 10 components move to the first machine. Now our target is to arrange this machine in a proper sequence where the distribution of these parts is smooth. So this I'll first explain what are the different steps involved in this Euler method, and then we'll take an example of this from to chart, and then we'll explain this complete method. So this method has a different steps. So first what we do is we develop the from to chart. So this is the from to chart, from where we get the information how the number of parts are moving from one machine to the other machine. The second one is we determine the sum of the from and to for each machine. So let's say for example, if we need to calculate the sum for the from, so from sum, let's say from machine 1, the summation will be, if we will add all these part number, so this will be 30. Similarly from for machine 2, that will be 45. So that shows the from sum for a machine is determined adding the entries in the corresponding rows. Similar to this, we can also calculate the two sums while after adding all the, let's say, the entries in the column one. Now, so this is shows the how we calculate this sums for the from and to. Now the third step is, after calculating these sums, we select the minimum from or minimum two sums, the numbers, and then minimum two, let's say if the minimum value is a two sum, then machine is placed at the beginning of the sequence, and if the minimum is, let's say, from sum, then machine will be placed at the end of the sequence. If there is a tie between the minimum two sum and the minimum from sum, then we select the minimum from to two ratio. Whichever the machine we select the minimum value, we eliminate that. So that is the fourth step. Reformat the from to chart by eliminating the row and column corresponding to the selected machine. So whatever the minimum value we get from the to sum or the from sum, we eliminate that, and then again reformat the from and to chart, and then again repeat the step 3 and 4 for the all assigned machines. Now we'll take this example for arranging machine in a group technology cell. So this example is, there are four machines in a cell. Now these machine, 50 parts are, let's say, processed on this machine, which has been summarized in the from to two chart. So this is the summary given how the parts are moving from one machine to the other machine. Now what we need to determine in this is logical machine arrangement using Euler method. Now this Euler method, which will apply, the additional information which is given here is how many number of parts, let's say, moving from one machine to the other. So it shows 50 parts enter the machine grouping at the machine 3, 20 parts leave after processing at the machine 1, and 30 parts leave after machine 4. So this information we will just, let's say, for time being, we'll keep on the hold, but the mainly the information which is useful for time being is the this one, from to chart. Now we'll apply the Euler method on this. So first step will be preparing the chart. The chart is the, this is the chart which we have, let's say, prepared, and then we have calculated the sum for from and for to. So this is the from sum, is the summation of these all numbers for different rows, and then two sums will be summation of these all entries for the column. Now the step will be to select the minimum, whichever is there from the from sum or from, maybe from the two sums. So what we can see is the minimum value is the zero. So this minimum one we will eliminate. So it means the machine 3 will eliminate from here, and the new chart will form, which will be this. And then if we'll again apply the step 2, then we'll do the summation for the from sum and then for the two sums, and then we find this for the 45, 40, 30, 45, 10. Again we look which one is the minimum, and what we realize is, after, let's say, eliminating the machine 3 in the previous steps, if that is from the 2, that will be in the beginning of the sequence. So we have kept the 3. So this will be, let's say, the result, or let's say the sequence of the machine will be in this form. 3, then another machine will come, another machine, and the another. So first machine place is fixed, which is third. Now second one is the, what we see here is fifth number. So it means we will eliminate this second machine also, and we'll keep here, and then again we apply the this, again we do the summation, and we see which one is the minimum is. So minimum from the two, if we see here is the 10, So that will be, again, we will eliminate one and then finally will be the four. So this is the procedure which we follow to arrange this machine in a sequence. So this sequence has been done now, 3, 2, 1, and 4. So this sequence is within a machine cell, will be the sequence. Now how to, let's say, provide this more information which was given. So this is the, let's say, the, for example, so the flow diagram is shown here in this 3, 2, 1, and 4 for the machine. And then how much parts are, let's say, getting in and out also we can draw here with the help of the information which was given in the question itself. So it says 50 parts enter the machine grouping at the machine 3. So it means at the 3 machine 50 parts enter and then 20 parts leave after processing. So it's like a 20 parts leave after the processing from the machine 1 and 30 part leave from the machine 4. So this 30 part are leaving from here. So it's like a in 50 component, out is also 50 components. So in between there is a, let's say, the processing thing is happening between the different combination of machine in a cell. Now this information has been already given in the, let's say, our from to two chart if you look. So here it mentioned from machine 1, 25 component move to the 4. So from machine 1, 25 component move to the 4. So it means it's like a 25 components are moving. For machine 2, 30 components are moving to the machine 1. From 2, 30 components are moving to the machine 1. For machine 3, 10 components are moving to the 1 and 40 to the 2. So from machine 3, 10 components are moving to the 1 and 40 are moving to the 2. And then from machine 4, 10 components are moving to the 1. From machine 4, 10 components are moving to the 1. So this shows within a GT cell how to arrange the machines to get the maximum output or maximum efficient process when the material or let's say parts are moving from one machine to the other machine. So these machines can be different lathe machine, milling machine, other combination of machines, and where these will be the components where they are moving from one machine to the other machine. So this is shows the how to arrange the machines in a group technology cell. So these are the references has been used. Thank you.